In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure BlackBerry UEM to enroll Apple DEP devices. The Apple DEP, or Device Enrollment Program, allows you to simplify the setup process by automating the enrollment and supervision processes for your users. I'll give a quick overview of the steps, and then we'll jump into a demo of how to do it, with lots of tips along the way. When you configure BlackBerry UEM to enroll Apple DEP devices, you perform the following actions. Create a DEP account, download a public key from BlackBerry UEM, log into the Apple Business Manager portal and create an MDM server, generate a server token on the Apple Business portal and save it to your computer, register the server token with BlackBerry UEM, create a DEP enrollment configuration, assign your Apple DEP devices to the MDM server, assign the DEP enrollment configuration to the Apple DEP devices. If not already done, configure your users with the IT policies and profiles required by your organization. Assign the BlackBerry UEM client and any additional apps, such as the BlackBerry Dynamics apps, to your Apple DEP users. If the user is a local user, you'll have to configure the activation password. Active Directory users don't need an activation password. Prepare the device for the user and give it to them. Once the user has the device, they can complete the setup. In this demo, I'm going to show you the most common setup used when administrators want to activate and manage Apple DEP devices. Before we jump into the demo, though, there are a few things you should complete before you begin the configuration for Apple DEP. You must register your APNS certificate before you can configure Apple DEP in BlackBerry UEM. Enroll in Apple's Volume Purchase Program, or VPP, and configure your Apple VPP account in BlackBerry UEM. This is optional. However, it allows you to assign apps directly to your Apple DEP devices. When you assign it directly to the device, the user doesn't need to log into the Apple App Store. For more information on setting up your APNS certificate and adding your Apple VPP account to BlackBerry UEM, visit docs.blackberry.com and search for Obtaining an APNS Certificate or Add an Apple VPP Account. All right, let's get started. We'll log into BlackBerry UEM and go to Settings, External Integration, Apple Device Enrollment Program. Click the plus icon to create a new Apple DEP account. This screen helps guide you through the main steps for configuring your Apple DEP account with BlackBerry UEM. I'll type in a name, and then I'll go to step one of the DEP account registration process. If you don't have an Apple DEP account, you'll have to create one. Click Create an Apple DEP account to open the Apple Business Manager portal. You'll be taken to a website where you can start the process for creating your Apple DEP account. Once you've completed the process and your Apple DEP account is created, you can either create your MDM server or return to BlackBerry UEM and proceed to step two. In this video, I already have an Apple DEP account created, so to streamline the process, I'm going to wait to set up my MDM server until I get to step three. For now, let's move on to step two. I'll click Download Public Key and save it to my computer. Now, let's go to step three. We'll log into the Apple Business Manager portal, where we'll perform several actions. We'll create our MDM server and upload the public key we downloaded in step two. Then we'll download the server token. All right, let's create our MDM server and upload the public key. I'll click Settings, Device Management Settings, and then I'll click Add MDM Server. In the MDM Server Information field, I'll type a name for the MDM server. I'm going to allow the MDM server to release devices. And next, I'm going to click Upload File and select the public key we downloaded from BlackBerry UEM. And I'll click Save to create the MDM server. Now that the MDM server is created, I'll click Download Token to save the token. Let's head back to BlackBerry UEM and register the server token we downloaded when we created our MDM server. We'll click Browse and select the server token. I'll click Open. And I'll click Save. After you save your Apple DEP configuration, BlackBerry UEM automatically displays the window where you add your first DEP enrollment configuration. To create the DEP enrollment configuration, we need to give it a name. This is the only required item, however, there are some important features here that you should be aware of. You can automatically assign all new devices to this configuration. You can include the department and the support number that will show on the user's device. In the device configuration section, you have allow pairing. If selected, users compare the device with a computer. Enable supervised mode. If selected, devices are activated in supervised mode. You must select at least one of enable supervised mode or allow removal of MDM profile. Mandatory. If selected, users cannot skip applying the DEP enrollment configuration. Allow removal of MDM profile. If selected, users have the ability to deactivate their device using the UEM client or device management settings from the DEP device. Wait until device is configured. If selected, users cannot cancel the device setup until activation with BlackBerry UEM is completed. This setting is valid only if you select Enable Supervised Mode. Skip during setup allows you to make the setup easier for your users by skipping some of the regular setup steps for iOS devices during the out-of-box experience. Once you've chosen your configuration options, click Save. Let's switch back to the Apple Business Manager portal and assign our DEP devices to the MDM server. I'll click Device Assignments. You have three methods to choose from to add your devices. Since I am only adding one device, I'm going to use the serial number method. Please see the Apple documentation for information on how to use the other methods. I'm going to paste my serial number in the field. From the Perform Action dropdown, I'll select Assign to Server. I'm going to choose the server I just created, and I'll click Done. Now we have to assign the DEP enrollment configuration to the device we registered to the MDM server. Let's switch back to BlackBerry UEM. In the left menu, click Users, Apple DEP Devices. Select all the devices you want to assign the enrollment configuration to and click the Assign Enrollment Configuration icon. Select the configuration you want to assign to the selected devices and click Assign. Now you'll see that the configuration is displayed in the Enrollment Configuration column. Next, I'm going to set up an activation profile. The important thing to know about the activation profile is that you can only activate Apple DEP devices with an activation type of MDM controls. If you want to configure other devices using the same profile, for example, if you want to configure Android, BlackBerry, or Windows devices using that profile, you can absolutely do this. However, the devices using Apple DEP must use MDM controls only. In this demo, I'm going to use this activation profile solely for Apple DEP devices. I'll put in a name so I know what I'm using it for, and I'm going to leave iOS selected and deselect all other device types. I'm also going to ensure that the iOS device activation type is for MDM controls, which it is, and I'll click Add. I'm not going to include BlackBerry Secure Connect Plus in this video, so I'm going to create an enterprise connectivity profile that turns it off for my Apple DEP device. I'll click Network and Connections, Enterprise Connectivity, and then click the plus icon. I'll enter a name, then I'll click the iOS tab and make sure that Enable BlackBerry Secure Connect Plus is not selected, and I'll click Add. Now let's add the activation profile to the users. Click Users, All Users, and search for the user. Click the user's name and open their profile. In the IT Policies and Profiles section, click the plus icon and then click Activation. I'll select the activation profile I named Apple DEP from the list and I'll click Assign. I'm also going to assign an email profile and the enterprise connectivity profile to the user. Next, we need to assign the BlackBerry UEM client to the user. And I'm also going to assign a BlackBerry Dynamic app as well. I'll click the plus icon and search for UEM. You'll notice that two apps appear. You should only select the one with the app name BlackBerry UEM Client. This app also has the OS column filled in and there's no lock icon. I'm also going to assign BlackBerry Work, which is a BlackBerry Dynamics app, and another non-BlackBerry app. I'll click Next. The BlackBerry UEM client is required to complete the enrollment process, so I'm going to change the disposition to required. I'm also going to change BlackBerry Work to required as well, so it's automatically pushed to the device. We'll leave the other app for the end user to install manually. I'll click Next. You'll see a window that asks you, do you want to assign licenses to these apps? This allows you to take one of the VPP licenses and you can choose to assign it to the user or the device. In the column App License, select your license, and in the Assign License To column, I'll select Device for both the BlackBerry UEM client and BlackBerry Work apps. I'll leave the other app set to User. By assigning the license to the device, the users won't have to log into the Apple App Store before the app is installed. Since my user is in the Active Directory, we don't need to set up an activation password for them. They can complete the activation using their Active Directory username and password. If the user is a local user, however, then you need to set an activation password. And there are a couple of things that you should know about. For the activation option, Apple DEP must use the default device activation, even though we've assigned the user a custom activation profile. Don't select the option Device Activation with Specified Activation Profile. Also, you can select an Apple DEP activation email template to use. So now everything is configured for the user in BlackBerry UEM. I've erased the device and it's ready to give to the user to complete the setup. When the user turns on the device, they'll proceed through the initial out-of-box experience setup. Let's go through the steps to activate the Apple DEP device I just configured so you can see what the user will see when they activate the device. I'll press the Home button. I'll select my language. I'll select my country. I'm going to join my Wi-Fi network. The activation process begins. It may take a few minutes. I'll tap Next to allow BlackBerry UEM to configure my device. Now I need to log in. Since I'm using my Active Directory information, I don't need an activation password. I just log in with my corporate username and password. It's important for your user to know that when they log in using their corporate username, they need to enter their username in the following format: domain/username. This information would be good to include in your Apple DEP activation email template. I'll tap Next. BlackBerry UEM is going to start configuring my device. Once the configuration is done, the welcome screen appears. I'll tap Get Started. At this point, the device is activated and talking to the BlackBerry UEM server. The server will automatically push any required apps down to the device and install them, except for any BlackBerry Dynamics apps. For BlackBerry Dynamics apps to be pushed down and installed, the enrollment process must be complete. One issue that users sometimes have is that they don't open the BlackBerry UEM client to complete the enrollment process. Instead, they go directly to their work apps and can't locate any of the BlackBerry Dynamics apps. As you can see here, when we open work apps on this device, we don't see the BlackBerry Work app we assigned as a required app. In order for it to appear, we must complete the enrollment process first. Let's do that now. I'll tap the UEM client to open it. I'll accept the license agreement. The app then continues the activation process. You can see each group of tasks it's performing scroll up the screen. Since we're also going to install a BlackBerry Dynamics app, we'll need to set a password for the UEM client. Once all the setup tasks are complete, the main screen of the BlackBerry UEM client appears. You'll see a prompt to enable remote notifications. This turns this feature on so the server can use it. I'll tap OK. Now that it's turned on, you'll need to allow the UEM client to send you notifications. I'll tap Allow. You can tap anywhere on the screen to dismiss the info screen. If we tap the launcher icon, you'll only see the UEM client app in the list. Let's switch back to the home screen. Since we set BlackBerry Work as a required app and the enrollment process is complete, the server is in the process of downloading and installing it. If we open the Work app again, we can see that BlackBerry Work now appears in the list of available apps. The first time you open a BlackBerry Dynamics app, you must complete a few steps. I'll go through the first time setup for BlackBerry Work. I'll tap the BlackBerry Work icon, and I'll tap Allow so BlackBerry Work can send me notifications. You can configure BlackBerry Work using the UEM client or using an access key provided by your administrator. For this demo, I'm going to use the BlackBerry UEM client type. I'll type my UEM client password that I created earlier and tap OK. I'll enter a password for BlackBerry Work. I set the same password for all of my BlackBerry Dynamics apps for convenience, So I'm going to use the same password I used for the BlackBerry UEM client. I'll read the license agreement and tap I agree. I'll enter my corporate password. And again, you can tap anywhere on the screen to dismiss the info screen. You'll see the emails start to appear in the inbox as the work app syncs to the server. If we tap the launcher icon now, you'll see other items like calendar and contacts in the list now that BlackBerry Work is configured. When we go back to BlackBerry UEM and look at the list of Apple DEP devices in BlackBerry UEM, we can see that the device is activated to our user. Here are a few things to remember. Apple DEP devices can only be activated using an activation profile that uses MDM controls. Make sure that you assign the correct BlackBerry UEM client app to your user. Because DEP device activity happens only once during the out-of-box experience, any DEP-related actions made in BlackBerry UEM will not have any effect on DEP devices that are already activated. And after the UEM client is installed on the device, the UEM client must be launched and the enrollment process complete before BlackBerry Dynamics apps will display in Work apps.